Hello, I'm JB Friday with the Cooperative Extension Program at the University of Hawaii. Today we're on the island of Yap in Federated States of Micronesia. With me is Dr. Muru and Stephen Young-Uhk, who are with the Cooperative Research Extension Program here at the College of Micronesia-FSM on the Yap campus. Dr. Muru and Mr. Young-Uhk have created a way of taking local coconut and milling it up to make cocoa peat and cocoa coir. And from this cocoa coir, they're making an excellent potting mix that they're able to use for both their vegetable production and their forestry production. So they're going to explain to us today how they do this. So Dr. Muru, what was the need that you saw for creating this?
Thank you, Dr. Friday, for giving us this opportunity to explain this the methods that we have been using. Mm-hmm. And as you said, we have been using this cocoa peat medium actually for over 15 years now for growing vegetables here in Yap. When we started this program, we had some challenges with using the native soil for growing vegetables, especially in the container gardening methods, because of the clay content of the soil.
Okay.
We have principally two types of soil on Yap proper, and we have much clay content. This is cyst-derived soil on the central part, and then we have a degraded volcanic red soils. Both gives different kinds of challenges, but in general, both has clay content is more. So water becomes stagnant actually when we use it in the containers.
So you'd really poor drainage in your containers.
Poor drainage, as well as when we use the topsoil, especially the tomatoes and bell peppers, we used to get a lot of nematode problems actually.
Okay, right.
And of course, other pathogens actually. So we were looking for other options. I hail from India and Kerala, of course. We have been using this cocoa peat medium for growing horticultural purposes and horticultural vegetables for quite a long time.
But so in India, you have big factories making that.
That's correct. Yeah. So here we have been looking for this one, and then we found out that a lot of locally coconut husk is available. Generally, people use the coconut, just split it and then feed the pigs the meat and then just throw it. So we found out that this one is a useful material actually. So we collect from the communities now and then chop it like this one in terms of small pieces and then use the ordinary shredder, compost shredder, and then shred it and do a fluffy medium actually.
Great.
Yeah.
So let's step through the process.
And there are many advantages of using this one. The first thing is that it's locally available and then we can source it from the communities from the surroundings and then convert it into the usable form. The second thing is that it's a very porous material actually. So once the medium is ready and when you pack it in containers, roots can easily penetrate and there will be a lot of aeration. And cocoa peat has a capacity of holding the moisture. And results found out that actually it can hold 8 times of its body weight water. So even if you forget one day to water the plants, it can still hold the moisture. And it's like a spongy material. So, and it's relatively inert material. Of course, we have to add a lot of other fertilizer or nutrient materials in this one. The good thing is that it comes without any pathogens. So it's a sterile material actually. So plants, we can get rid of the problems which we usually get it from the topsoil.
We use all kinds of coconut husk. We use 3 kinds, fresh ones, partially decomposed, and fully decomposed coconut husk. This is the fresh coconut husk that we can chop and put in the shredder machine and produce the coconut coir. So we get fresh coconut husk, and because they're tough, we have to chop them up in smaller pieces and shred them. And then once we shred them, we produce this. Sometimes we screen them out to remove the bigger fibers, and the remaining we use for our plants. While this takes a little bit longer and a little bit hard work to prepare, we like the fresh coconut husk because they last longer when we plant vegetables or trees. So this is partially decomposed, the coconut husk. It's been about 6 to a year. So we can we go out and collect them and use them. And we chop them up also into smaller pieces so they're easier to shred. And we produce materials that are a little bit better than the fresh ones because we can use everything. We don't have to screen. It's also a little bit better than the decomposed, the fully decomposed, because they last longer. In 3 or 4 production cycles before we have to replace them.
This is the naturally decomposed coconut husk. We use this because it's easier to work with, easy to shred in the machine.
We have to cut up the coconut husk to make them smaller so we can put them through the shredder machine and produce the coconut coir that we need.
This is the cheapest shredder that we use it for shredding this chopped coconut husk. It's 250 cc powerful engine this has. And it's an ordinary compost shredder, actually, that's what they call it as. And this is what we use, the chopped coconut husk. We put it in and then start the machine, go on rolling it, and then shred the coconut husk into fine potting media. We will get it. Yeah, this is the freshly collected husk, which has already shredded. As you see, we can see a little bit more not completely shredded fiber materials. So before we start using it in the poly bags or in the containers, it is better to sieve it. Now, George is doing actually sieving this one, the coarse shredded material. Now, as you see, you can see the pith will be collected at the bottom in the wheelbarrow, and the coarse fiber which has not shredded properly, we can still collect it and then re-shred it. Now, after sieving, the coarse material is being left aside, and you can see as here the sieved material, it's a fine coir pith without any large coarse fiber materials.
Now that we have the coconut husk, the prepared material, we are ready to mix with chicken manure for the planting medium. To prepare the planting medium, we use 3 parts coconut husk and 1 part chicken manure. 3-to-1 ratio is about a wheelbarrow of coconut husk to 1 bag of chicken manure. The end results are the vegetables that we are producing using the coconut husk. The medium is well aerated. They hold moisture, so they're good for growing vegetables. We produce healthy vegetables for the market as well as for home consumption.